So when you install Splunk Enterprise, it comes with roles that control what users are able to do within the Splunk instance. So what you have to do is create a user, and depending on the kind of permissions or capabilities that you want the user to have within the Splunk instance or installation, you assign the corresponding role to them. So these roles have capabilities, and it's these capabilities that determine what the user that has that role assigned is able to do. So when Splunk comes out of the blocks, there are actually five roles. As you see listed here, admin, you know, can delete and all that. But we focus on three main roles because those are the three main roles that you can actually assign to users when you are creating them within your Splunk instance. The first one is the user role. And the user role is the one that has the least capabilities. So it's access to settings is limited. Remember, we were talking when we discussed the home app, that when you go to the settings menu, and if you have only the user role, you will not be able to see all the menu items. And then this role can only create private knowledge objects. So when you have a user role, you can create your own knowledge objects, but you will not have the ability to share them so that other users can see, even though you can see what other users create. And then, so if you have a basic user, maybe someone that is just starting in Splunk, and they don't really have the ability to do way too much, they are still learning, you might want to assign them the user role. The next higher level role after that is what you call the power role. And with the power role, you still have limited access to settings because you'll not be able to see all those menu items. But the good thing with the power role is that you can create and publish or share knowledge objects. So if you created a dashboard, it's possible for you to share that dashboard so that other people can see. But with the user role, you are not able to do that. And then, so if you want somebody to be a power user, you can assign them the power role. And then the admin role is the one that has the most capabilities. So it has access to all the settings. And all along this course, we are going to be connected and using the admin role because we want to have access to all the settings so that you can see everything that Splunk has. So when you install Splunk, as I said before, you automatically become the admin. That means that the admin role is being assigned to you. So it has the most capabilities, as we've said, and so you assign this to Splunk admins. Now, what do you really do now when you are creating a user? All you need to do, you have a user that comes in. Suppose that you are the administrator of a Splunk instance or maybe a Splunk deployment in an organization. And then maybe new employees were hired and they have to work with it. And you have to make sure that these employees have access to Splunk. What do? You have to create users. So you take those users, you determine the role that they're going to have, you create the users, and then you assign the corresponding role to them. So as you see here, we have three users. One of them has the admin role, one has the user role, and then the other one has the power role. So in a demonstration here, we're just going to demonstrate users and roles quickly, and then we'll go ahead and create two users called jclode and mfrost, and then we'll give one of them the user role and then the other one the power role. Okay, so here we're back to our local instance of Splunk. We can access users and roles by going to the settings menu, and then we go under the sub menu for users and authentication. So let's click on users here. If you come to users, you see that there's only one user on this system. So this is the admin user that came with your installation of Splunk. So no additional users have been created here. If you go back and then we just go to roles, then you see the five roles that we spoke about. But we said that there are three main roles, admin, power, and user role that we can assign to users. And what these roles are controlled by, or what happens when you assign this role to users, they get the capabilities that are associated with the role. So each role has a certain set of capabilities. See, admin have capabilities, 119 native of them, and then 39 inherited. So let's go back to users and then see how we can add two new users, as we saw. So that's going to be part of our demonstration. We're going to go here to add user, and then the first user that we're going to create here, we'll call it jclode. And then we can put a full name. The full name here, we're going to go with Jean-Claude. And then the email address, I'm just going to do this. I will just put like jclode@company.com. Just something like this. And then for the password, I'm going to set a password here as well. I'm just going to do this. And then for the default time zone, we can leave it as default, but I'm going to say, okay, maybe these users are in Eastern time zone. So I want to give them Eastern time. So I can just go and say, maybe. Okay, so I'm going to assign Eastern time here for this user. And then for the default app, I'm going to leave it as the home app. And this is a case where maybe if you are using a Splunk instance or deployment in which you had a specific app that is created by for some department and this user is part of that department, then you can just pick that app from here and set as a default app. Now, this is where you assign the roles. These are the five roles that we saw. The user role is already selected here. I'm going to do this just so that no role is selected at this time and say that I wanted to assign the user role. What I'm going to do is just to pick this and then it's going to show the user role here for me. And then you see that require password change upon first login. So if this box is checked, it means that when this user is going to be logging into Splunk, it's going to ask the user to change their password. We don't want to go through that, so I'm going to uncheck this box here. And then I'm just going to do save. So when I do that, you see that it has created the first user for me. So J. Claude with the full name Jean Claude, and then all the information that we filled now has the user role assigned to them. So this user is going to have the list capabilities. Now let's create another user here. I'm going to create another user called mfrost. Then I'm going to put that name as Mary Frost. And then I'm just going to do an email here, which is going to be frost@company.com. I'm going to do that here. Then just put. Then again, for the time zone, I'm going to do GMT minus 5, which is our Eastern time. Bear with me. This one. And then I'm going to leave this the same. Now, I don't need the user role for this. So this is going to be our power user. So we select the power role for that. And then again, we don't want that when you log into the instance, it asks you to change your password. We're just doing a demonstration. So I'm going to uncheck this box here and I'm going to save. So those are the two new users that I've created. Now, what we are going to do is that we are going to log out because we are actually logged in as an admin user. And then we log in with each of these two users and just see how our instance is going to look like. So let me go back here and just log out as admin. And I'm going to log in first as J. Claude. I'm just going to put my password. A very basic password. Okay, so when you log in as J. Claude, you see your interface is not dark because the settings are different. So if you want to do that, of course, then you have to come and change the settings yourself and then put dark theme or whatever settings that you want to put. And now notice that if we go to settings menu, you see what I was talking about. You see only the knowledge menu and then under users and authentication, you have tokens. You don't see all the other sub-menu items. So that's why I was trying to insist that when you see this, if you go into Splunk and maybe you get hired somewhere as an employee and then you see this, you think there's a problem. It's not a problem. It's just simply because you have a user role. Okay, so we're going to log out again from Jean-Claude and then we log in now with the power user that we created as well. So log out here, and then I'm going to do here, I'm just going to do mfrost, and then put my password here. All right, so we log in as the power user now. And then if you go here again, you see the settings are default. So you can change your preferences and your account settings here. But if you go to the settings menu as well, you see that you have the knowledge menu. You have a little bit under data menu. Report acceleration, summary, source types, and then under user authentication, you have tokens. You don't have all the other menu items that you have with the admin user. So I'm going to log out.